Welcome to Genesis Unleashed, the program that unleashes the truth of Genesis.
And shows that what scientists are observing about mutations doesn't help evolution at all. Welcome back to Genesis Unleashed. Today we're going to talk about mutations. Mm-hmm. Now, evolution story, the basics for evolution are actually quite simple. It's mutations plus natural selection equals evolution from one kind to another. That's the basic formula to that drives evolution forward, or so we're told. Yeah. And at that level, that seems to make sense. Mutations are supposed to provide the changes in living things, the new genetic information, right. New useful functions and features, and natural selection selects the best of those features.
Right.
It sounds very reasonable.
Yeah, if there's a survival benefit for some new genetic information that produces some new feature, then that would make sense. And that would, if that's actually happening, then evolution would have a plausible mechanism.
Sure. But there are, of course, some hiccups with that. If, for example, if mutations produce the wrong kind of change, a downhill change, where they're actually deleting and destroying new functions and features, or they're not producing anything new at all, if they're actually going the wrong way, then evolution is in big trouble. Then
right.
Natural selection has nothing to select from, and you've got a problem. So we'll talk about genetics. Genetics is a very fast-moving field. The science of genetics is, they're discovering so many new things all the time. It's incredible.
Right.
And what's recently been discovered is that mutations don't help evolution at all.
Right. I mean, mutations are a genetic copying error. That's what's happening with those letters in the DNA.
Yeah, a typo in the, yes.
That's right. And so we recently interviewed Dr. John Sanford. And
we did.
Caught up to John and asked him, you know, okay, well, what are scientists observing today? Because that's what science is based on, right? It's based on observations, and then you're going to make predictions out of that. Now, if you don't know who Dr. John Sanford is, I'm just going to read a little bit of his bio because he's quite well known in the field of science. He was a Cornell University professor for more than 25 years. He's been semi-retired since 1998. His PhD was in plant breeding and plant genetics. He was involved in conventional breeding of new crop varieties and then became heavily involved in the newly emerging field of plant genetic engineering. So he's published over 80 scientific publications, has been granted over 30 patents. His most significant scientific contributions involve three inventions. The biolistic gene gun. He invented the gene gun. pretty amazing technology.
Fairly well known in the genetic community.
Yeah, exactly. Pathogen-derived resistance and genetic immunization. So those are the three areas. And a large fraction of the transgenic crops grown in the world today were genetically engineered using the gene gun technology developed by John and his collaborators. So he started two biotech enterprises derived from his research, and he still holds a position at Cornell. He's a courtesy associate professor, but he's largely retired now. He's still a really, really busy guy.
He's a busy guy,
yeah.
So he's hard to get a hold of. But
yeah.
As you can see, he's no slouch in the genetics community. He's not just
right.
You know, just out of university or something. He's he's gone through the whole gamut of genetic engineering and so on. As we said, we recently caught up with him, and here's what he had to say about good versus bad mutations, or the nature of mutations in general.
See, everyone understands in genetics that almost all mutations are bad. A lot of them are nearly neutral, but essentially none of them should be absolutely neutral. And to be beneficial, it's like a typographical error in a textbook. It could be beneficial, but it's not likely. It's unlikely with an extremely strong certainty.
Okay, so mutations, according to Dr. Sanford, who knows what's going on in the field of genetics,
right.
Are bad. They're incredibly bad. Now, there are, as he mentioned, there are beneficial, or there could be beneficial mutations, but in the scientific literature, even all of those that are described as beneficial still lead to degradation of information.
Right.
They provide a benefit, but genetically, they're actually deleting information. The ratio of the good or beneficial, we can use that term, beneficial mutations versus the harmful information deleting mutations that destroy things is about 1,000,000 to 1.
Your odds aren't that great.
No, they're not that great. And people might be thinking, well, then evolution could still work, right? Because if you
right, because you've got that 1 in a million chance. Yep.
Yes, you're admitting beneficial mutations.
Yeah.
But just, regardless of how beneficial your mutation is, let's say you have a huge benefit in one mutation. You get from scales to feathers. Dinosaur to bird evolution, or reptile to bird evolution, if you want to think
virtually
of it
that instantaneously
way. In one mutation, it's a huge benefit moving evolution forward. You've now got 1,000,000 bad mutations that come after that one and destroy every other cell in the body.
Right, it's kind of like a supercharger. You mount it on your car. You've got something brand new. It's providing you all this new stuff, but then you're going to have 1,000,000 years of rust. Right, all that just eating away. It's like mutations become like termites in a house, where it's just like little nips at a time. You're just getting less and less and less. Right.
Right.
Yeah. So these beneficial mutations that we see touted,
they're supposed to be the building blocks of life, right? Mutations plus natural selection equals evolution.
Yeah. Yeah. But what are world-leading scientists actually observing? Well, back to John, and we'll see what he has to say about this.
One of the things, as I looked at the literature and what other people were saying in the field, is I found that basically all human geneticists acknowledge that we are degenerating at present. And some of them think that we're degenerating very rapidly.
Okay, so all geneticists agree that we're actually degenerating through mutations. So we're actually not evolving according to what we observe. We're devolving, I guess you could say.
Right. What does this mean for evolution?
And I started reading the population genetics literature more carefully, and I realized that all the leading population geneticists understood this problem and had at some place or another in their writings mentioned it, but never announced it to the world or announced it even to the scientific community. It's kind of one of those just little trade secrets that population geneticists know. And the reason it's a trade secret is because it's lethal to neo-Darwinian theory. It's lethal to the evolutionary point of view. And so, for example, I ran across a paper called "Why Aren't We Dead 100 Times Over?" written by a leading population geneticist who was acknowledging that mutations are happening too fast and that we can't select them away as fast as they accumulate, and that in evolutionary time we should be dead 100, the way he expressed it was, we should be dead 100 times over. And so there's numerous, I started to see more and more papers like that where I could see that population geneticists understood the problem and didn't have good answers, but weren't advertising the problem. It was like, it's a fascinating issue, isn't it? Most people would be really interested to know. But it was, like I said, I believe a trade secret.
A trade secret among evolutionists. That's an interesting terminology.
Yeah.
But of course, again, there's that popular equation, mutations plus natural selection equals evolution. Now we've got this trade secret among geneticists who know what's going on,
right,
saying that's not going to work. Evolution doesn't work that way because mutations are causing things to go to extinction, not evolution.
Right. Now we're going to have more, we're going to feature Dr. Sanford in more episodes of Genesis Unleashed, so stay tuned for those. And you can go to creation.com and just search on mutations for a whole bunch of information in this topic. But we also recommend that you get Dr. Sanford's book, Genetic Entropy and the Mystery of the Genome. This is a fantastic book. Go to creation.com. You can order that from our website as well. It's just a great read.